So I want to talk a little bit about types of functions and how we classify functions. And one of the major function classifications that we have is called a polynomial. Polynomials are made up of smaller pieces that look like this, kind of like 3x cubed. There's this first piece called the coefficient, right? You guys remember this language. And then there's this piece called the exponent. And in R, for this thing to be called a monomial, this whole thing, this exponent has to be a whole number. So it can be 0, 1, 2, but like a counting number. Okay. If it's a fraction, if it's a negative number, if it's anything other than a whole number, this is not a monomial. And so we call things polynomials when we add monomials or subtract monomials from each other. So an example of a polynomial is f of x is equal to, say, for example, 5x to the 7th plus 3x squared minus 5. and you can have as many kind of monomials in here as you want. This highest exponent, or the biggest exponent, is called the degree of the polynomial. Okay. So these are the main types. I want to make a note right here when we talk about domain, and from the previous work, the domain of all polynomials, they're very nice. The domain is minus infinity to infinity. There's nothing in the denominator. There's nothing that we need to exclude. Minus infinity to infinity. Now, there are more specific types of polynomials that you know, and I've written them down here. So, for example, the constant function, f of x is equal to just a number here, is called the constant function. That's a polynomial, and it's the domain is still here, minus infinity to infinity. Linear functions as well have the same domain. Those look like y is equal to mx plus b, or f of x is equal to mx plus b, something like this. Quadratic functions are polynomials of degree 2. Linear functions have degree 1. And constant functions have degree 0. So quadratic functions look like this. You'll probably remember the ax squared plus bx plus c. And we use that. That's the same a, b, and c as in the quadratic formula. Cubic functions, degree 3. All of these have the same domain, minus infinity to infinity. And same with this higher degree here. This is degree 4, this other one is degree 17. But those are all polynomials. Okay? But we understand, for example, there are some other. I'm going to look at some pictures of these in a minute because different degrees indicate different kind of looks on the graph. We also have rational functions. These have limits to the domain based on what might cause zero in the denominator. So these both over here are rational functions. And then functions involving radicals also have limited domain. And we talked about those and how to find those in the domain video, so I won't re-go over that. These different functions look different when you graph them, so I have, let me see if I can get it to come up. There we go. So, for example, you remember linear functions are called linear functions because they look like straight lines. Constant functions look like horizontal lines. This is a constant function here. Where m is 0, it has 0 slope and it's a horizontal line. Quadratic functions have this typical parabola shape, this U or upside down U. So you'll see when you're graphing, you should expect to get this shape or upside down shape when you graph quadratics. For polynomials bigger than degree 2, it can look like this. So here's a third degree polynomial, or degree 3. It tends to look kind of like this shape, more or less. Degree 4, and mostly it can kind of start down and go up, or it can go the other way, kind of get flipped over. Degree 4 looks something like this, and degree 5 here. Okay, that you see here, polynomials are really nice and smooth. They don't have sharp edges. They kind of have these big hills and valleys that you'll see. Rational functions, we'll talk more about the graphs. I just kind of want you to be, this is like a broad overview about what these graphs look like. They have big gaps in the graph, what I call kind of chasms in the graph, vertical asymptotes, if you remember that word. Where the function is not defined, so these are based on the domain. But then aside from that, they can get pretty complex depending on what the function looks like. Okay, so I'm going to post this as a PDF so that you can kind of use it for reference when you're classifying. Classifying functions can help you then when you're solving equations, like solving for x-intercepts, when you're also graphing the function too. So think about one of the first steps when you're working with functions is to classify them and figure out what it is. Okay?